same rules that apply to every other building out there. I mean, when they come up with the water hotel, same thing. Still going to be got a sprinkler system in there. Still going to have to have one of that. The fire hotel, still have to have a sprinkler system in there.
Of course.
But if you had a fire hotel, if you said it is a hotel of fire, you would still have to have a sprinkler system in case of a fire. That's their justification, because as long as it's a new building, that's what you're going to have. Folks, this is the nonsense. There's no more case-by-case basis. Let's use our head, our intelligence, and say, what is appropriate about it? It's a square peg in a round hole, because that is what the Big Brother has demanded. An ice hotel that now has to have a sprinkler system and fire alarm. Well, good luck with that.
Autumn Blaze with Doc Thompson. Only on the Blaze Radio Network. On the next Buck Sexton Show.
So we're back from stuffing our faces with turkey and standing in lines over Black Friday, or maybe you decided not to go that route and stay at home. Whatever you did, this week we're going to talk about Obamacare. We're going to talk about the Middle East. We're going to talk about everything that's being done right now to make you think the past year has not been a disaster for progressives. We're going to break it all down on the Buck Sexton Show.
Buck Sexton. Saturdays at noon Eastern on the Blaze Radio Network.
Hi, this is Stuart here. I spent a lot of time thinking about the direction we're headed in this country, so I found myself quite motivated to find a way to protect my family's future. The most exciting opportunity I've discovered is buying property in the country of Belize. First off, Belize is an English-speaking country with favorable tax laws, a strong banking system, a stable economy, and a real estate market that's been growing for the last 25 years. Belize offers a remarkably low cost of living and some of the most breathtaking scenery on Earth. I know, I went there to check it out, and I was blown away. We all want options. Belize offers a truly unique combination of real estate investment, asset protection, and tax savings.
young children, so they would qualify for Medicaid benefits. The FBI is saying 58 of the 63 births of babies to Russian diplomats and their spouses in New York City between 2004 and 2013 funded by Medicaid, while at the same time the couple spending thousands of dollars on vacations, designer clothes, and expensive jewelry. The case likely to not go to trial because the defendants have immunity.
Colorado, a judge is saying that a baker who refused to bake a wedding cake for a gay wedding has to serve gay couples despite his religious beliefs. Masterpiece Cake Shop in Denver will face fines by continuing to turn away business from gay couples who want cakes for their weddings. Nicole Martin, the attorney for the cake shop's owner, Jack Phillips, says Phillips would rather go out of business than communicate a message that he believes is wrong.
The judge is going to be forced to violate his conscience. He will not be 20 days. He just won't violate his conscience.
that's what I'm saying. This is proven that Glenn and I get it. We're together on this stuff. We're patriots. We drive together in this fight for truth, justice, American values.
Where people learning stuff, Randy's turned in. For a case of ramen, it was my kitchen friend who bombed your website at the weekend. You're throwing some red blood. We can knock down to about 30 hours.
Yeah, right. That's to each coach in this, this battle that one has to. The right way to do things, American values. I'm riding shotgun with it. You ride that drive and that team of horses, and there I am, shotgun. I get the back of the stuff, whatever. I'm in the trenches with them. I am in the trenches with them. See, I've always been there, but officially invited me in the trenches.
Last January, in the trenches.
Last January, man, when he said, come on in these trenches, and I brought my money skin down.
Does it mean I'm in the trenches?
You're in the trenches. Well, you're in a separate trench. We don't want you in our trench. That's okay. You're in a trench that's kind of covered our trench.
You share that trench with
That's right. Clem and I are right there. We're in the front.
Like, that doesn't mean that I'm sharing my trench with Callan.
With Callan, right down. Other people do. Well, I'm in the main trench. That's right there.
We get a snow cone machine in our trench.
Wow. You guys are taking this very seriously.
That sounds awesome.
We're in a battle here, man.
We get a snow cone. I don't think Glenn's going to come over to snow cone with the snow cones.
Just saying, well, I speak, but I'm just saying, you know the level of respect one has.
I do know the level of respect, you're right, I do know the level of respect.
Well, I'm glad you finally figured that out.
I don't know, you know.
I definitely.
Right on Hunter is also important. Well, the $800 from Patrick Henry's money book. See, the reason for that is it's actually in really, really bad shape right now. It is still a collector's item for what it is, but.
Well, there are multiple Patrick Henry
books. That is true.
He had a lot of books. If they were more unique, there were only a couple of them, they were in better shape, probably. Glenn has one of them. And we didn't say it was Patrick Henry of, you know, St. John's Church. People would have been doing that thing.
No.
It could be some other Patrick Henry.
That is true. That is true.
But I'm sure, knowing Glenn the way I do.
What is this? What's that? Where are you? This is Chase or Father.
All right, we'll get him in hashtag what I learned today.
I heard you in this church with me.
Say hi to him.
Right here, this giant king-sized trench with you.
I think you guys are taking this very seriously.
Thanks, Johnny.
So, you guys know the good work we're doing here. Know the good work. Glenn calls me up and lays out the future. His plan, sharing some of it with me.
Dude, he called while we were on the air. He knows we're on the air.
Listen.
Would it be the one sign that you would not answer if I would not answer my phone?
He got the point is, he returned the call and got the information out. We can't question Glenn's wisdom.
21 hours in the
airtime right now. You question Glenn Beck's wisdom in the way he does things. Having built this media empire, you
know. No, I think it's a brilliant idea. I'm questioning your wisdom and not realizing that he called through the one window of time you wouldn't be able to answer.
Glenn has a great deal of respect for me. And he knows, being the man of the people as I am, that if I know something, I'm looking out there. The cat's out of the bag if I know something. He knows that.
I know.
So he shares with me the stuff he can. He knows. He has a great deal of respect for my wanting the information out there. Like my quest for the truth. That's the reason he gives me the information. I would be much more centered in those meetings. If he respected me any less.
Okay, I'm just going to let you go with that.
It's his great deal of respect for me that keeps knowledge from me. But he has enough to give it to me when he has it. Return the call. This is important. All right, folks, I am going to lay out what I think is the... I don't even overstate what I say. It's probably in the top 10 list of the greatest piece of audio you will hear, maybe all year. And I'm not talking about that. It is an argument made laying out the need for the filibuster in the Senate. I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but yesterday's Senate progressives, all Democrats, eliminated the filibuster for most of the president's nominations. It is a clear power grab, and it is absolutely wrong. It doesn't matter if Republicans doing it or Democrats doing it. Whether Republicans are trying to do this or they didn't actually try to do it, they made a half-hearted attempt suggesting that they were going to do this. it's that common ground that we all have to search for. Not compromising our values, but common ground that we can all say, yes, of course, balancing our budget, of course that makes sense. That hasn't happened, has it? That balance our budget, something so simple, so fundamental in everybody's lives and business and government. It hasn't happened in forever. They haven't done that, but they managed to. With majority rule, use trickery to pass new rules, which will encourage more bad legislation to be passed, instead of good, common ground legislation. The Democrats in the Senate use this rare parliamentary trickery, this move, to change the rules so that federal judicial nominees, other appointments from the president, can get confirmed. Confirmed with votes by a simple majority of senators. A simple majority meaning 50-49, 41, or 51-49. They can simply get this done, rather than the 60-vote supermajority that has been the standard. What is wrong? What is wrong with wanting a supermajority? What's wrong with wanting an 80% majority? What's wrong with that? I mean, you have to allow for a couple of people that are just crazy here and there. You potentially, okay, throw out those couple. What's wrong with wanting 80 people, 80 senators to agree? Theoretically, if you get 80 senators to agree, you're probably going to be avoiding a lot of rigid ideology that these very people who pushed this through said, you've got to get rid of. That's what I hear from progressives all the time. Rigid ideology. That's code for the way America's supposed to be run, like. But with their very claims that rigid ideology is bad, shouldn't they say, yeah, absolutely, we got to get a majority that would prevent rigid ideology and people being staunchly in their camps. 80 senators, let's go 80%, sure. And do that. So you get 80 people, theoretically. You get a lot of people saying, this person is still a good person. This is still the right person for the job. Think about your office. There's probably a lot of people in your office that you don't agree with, politically speaking. But you probably respect the job they do. There's people like that I know. Many I do not. Why can't we approach it the same way? That's part of the reason for the filibuster. Now, this change represents a substantial power shift in a chamber that for more than two centuries has prided itself on affording more rights to the minority party than any other legislative body in the world. And they have changed. Now, I have a lodge coming up that will do a better job right now than I just went out. But first, I want to play for you what the president said yesterday about this. As the Senate met, as they were ruling, as they were on the navigating the waters of the boat, they started casting their votes. Some had gone out and spoke on this earlier in the day. The president comes out and gives his opinion on the nuclear option, as they call it. The nuclear option meaning getting rid of the filibuster. And here's what the president had to say.
For the past 5 years, we've seen an unprecedented pattern of obstruction in Congress that's prevented too much of the American people's business from getting done. Repeated abuse of these tactics to block legislation that might create jobs and defeated actions that would help women fight for equal pay. They prevented more progress than we would like to have, striving young immigrants, trying to earn their citizenship, or has blocked efforts to end tax breaks for companies that are shipping jobs overseas. They've even been used to block common sense and widely supported steps to protect all Americans from gun violence.
Pause this 1 second here. He's what the president is doing. He's laying out a team to get rid of the filibuster based on his ideas. You understand? You and I can come at this. We can get 100 people, 1 million people, whatever, to come at why something needs to be done. He's arguing get rid of it because these ideas, regardless of what the ideas are, whose ideas, supersede the process. And it shouldn't. It doesn't.
easier lead now that he's down to only one man without a
fight. It's chipping away. Here's a little more. President explained.
Yes, families of victims said it came to a watch. They prevented far too many talented Americans from serving their country at a time. And
do you see all the ideology he's bringing up? I'm going to stop there. I'm going to take a quick break, and I'm going to come back with a collage that will lay out the real need for the filibuster. It may be the best audio you hear all year. Quick break, and I'll come back with that in the morning.
Good morning, Flakes, with Don Thompson. Streaming stimulation measures. What's on the latest radio network?
Yeah. 90% of the time. It is amazing. It's almost a temper tantrum.
Mr. President, the right to extend the debate is never more important than when one party controls Congress and the White House. In these cases, a filibuster serves as a check on power and preserves our limited government.
The nuclear option, if successful, will turn the Senate into a body that could have its rules broken at any time by a majority of senators unhappy with any position taken by the minority. It begins with judicial...
No,
next will be...